We are not entirely sure who's actually read these speeches in sort of on a larger scale, because there is no evidence. But again, Cicero's letters present a great help in that respect, because we have some letters which are kind of covering notes, where he says, where he writes a letter to a friend, I enclose the speech that I gave on such and such an occasion. And sometimes he also says, I send you this speech, and please make sure to give a copy also to X. So we know for certain that Cicero sent round these letters to his friends. And sometimes he did so because he wanted to be admired for his rhetorical virtuosity. And sometimes he wanted to get his political views out and about. And even in cases where he doesn't ask the addressees to pass on the speech, it is very likely that they did so. So sort of in the first instance, that means the speeches sort of were passed on in the circle of educated peers of Cicero. And then from then on, they would have reached the wider public, even if not everyone might have read them. But the people who had read them would go about talking to them, and therefore it would reach a wider audience. How wide that precisely was, and how low down on the social scale it went, is very difficult to gauge, because there wasn't a kind of professional book selling process as there is now. It was more like you had slaves who made copies, and they made copies and copies, and so it went out and about within Roman Italy.